Scooter here, man on the inside, contributing writer, woodsmonkey.com. Today I'm reviewing the Gumdrop Cases iPad 2 Military Edition for an iPad 2. This is their heavy-duty case for the iPad. There's my trusty naked iPad. And in an environment I use it a lot, rebuilding something like a carburetor out here on my little garage, I'm often either looking at a manual or trying to figure something out. So I have PDF files of different items, like this old Land Rover carburetor, on my iPad. But I'm always with dirty hands working on something. Wait till you see this case. It's going to protect it really good, keep the thing clean, and hopefully protect it when I drop it. Basically, it's four pieces of polycarbonate. Got a back, the front rim, let's call it, the front screen protector, piece of polycarbonate there also, and the heavy-duty silicone rubber that covers the whole shebang. Nice heavy-duty corners. It's got raised pieces on the inside so that it will jive with the cover and hold it in place. It connects up really good. Got a setup there for the speaker. Ports and covers, either open or covered, for everything on the iPad, of course. So let's get this thing together. First, we have the back with a piece of plastic over the lens of the camera so that doesn't get damaged. That just sets right in there. Now, this is the screen cover piece, which I found out is replaceable. This whole cover goes for approximately $70, but you can replace this screen for about $15, I think, if you'd mess it up somehow. So that just kind of sits on there like that. This is the piece that keeps everything where it should be and connected. Now, there is definitely a top and bottom to this. And if you can see that these two little open areas here, this is the top. This is for part of the camera. This is where the home button goes, down here in the bottom. So that just sits right over top of the screen protector and snaps into the bottom piece. Look at all four corners, make sure you have it snapped in good. Even has a little piece of material here over the speaker to help protect that even more from dust and dirt. We've got our polycarbonate pieces on. We'll slide on the silicone here. Quite flexible, pretty durable stuff. I don't think you'd hurt it pulling it on there. I've had this case on and off numerous times, haven't hurt the silicone cover one bit. No tears, no rips, nothing like that. Make sure you take an extra minute and make sure that the silicone is seated into the plastic frame properly. Again, that'll help keep dust and dirt out of it. That's it. It should jive with these little black pieces, these little chevrons here. Art, I don't know if you can see this texture on here, but it adds a ton of traction to this thing. You know how slippery a stock iPad can be. This gives you plenty to grab onto, especially with dirty hands. And let me see if I can find my PDF file. Just like that. That's what I use a lot of times here in the shop, rebuilding dirty old Land Rover parts, something like this. You can get to all the buttons, home button. There's a little cover here for your screen orientation lock. Volume buttons, of course. Little port here for the headphones. And a nice big port on the bottom for the charging or syncing with your computer. That's nice. Again, got the holes in the bottom here for the speaker. Overall, it's a very heavy-duty case. I was out here maybe a week ago and it started to drizzle. Wasn't a full-on downpour, but it was drizzling, was wet out here. I wanted to continue doing what I was doing. I had this out with me, no problems. I wouldn't submerge it, or I wouldn't be standing out here in a heavy rain, but in a drizzle or something like that, and you want to finish up something, you got this thing with you, I wouldn't worry about it. Dust and dirt has been no problem with the thing so far. And I don't know if you can see, I got a little bit of grease on the back of this thing. No big deal. Haven't hurt the iPad one bit. Pretty heavy duty case. The only one complaint I do have is that the home button, I think the silicone that's behind there to touch on the actual button on the iPad is built up really high, and it doesn't take much effort at all to touch this button and make the lock screen come on your iPad, which might be good, might be bad. I keep this thing in a soft-sided briefcase on my way to work or just traveling about, and I've noticed that sometimes I look in the bag to get something out of the bag, the lock screen is lit up because it's bouncing around in there and the home button got hit. But it hasn't detracted from the battery. It's not like it's drawing the battery down. It certainly isn't unlocking because you gotta, of course, swipe it with your finger to do that. But other than that one little thing, this is a pretty heavy-duty case. This is the military edition. I think the regular DropTex series case is $10 less. I didn't see a ton of difference here. I think the material screen on the plastic is different. The color, of course, is different. You cannot get the military green in the regular series. Have to get this one. And that's a cool color anyway, right? Goes with the Land Rover. So, pretty heavy-duty case. You can find these on their website, gumdropcases.com. Remember, this is the military edition, and it goes for about 70 bucks, somewhere like that. There is a big Land Rover rally coming up this weekend. This is going with me, so there could be an update to the video or at least some more still photos or something. This is going on the rally, bouncing around the Land Rover all weekend. We'll see how it holds up. Okay. Scooter here, contributing editor, woodsmonkey.com. Thanks for watching.